Hello, Internet! Welcome to Data Science Dojo. My name is Phuc Duong, and I'm going to bring you another video tutorial series. This time, we're going to expand your data science toolkit by teaching you how to data mine using Azure Machine Learning Studio. This will be a multi-part video series, and who is this video series intended for? Well, it's anyone who wants to learn Azure Machine Learning Studio. And more importantly, Data Science Dojo hosts a 5-day bootcamp on data science and data engineering. It is an in-person bootcamp. It lasts 50 hours for an entire week. We go 8 to 5 every day, and this is one of the 5 modules that students have to learn before showing up on day 1. So we teach the class mainly in R and in Azure ML Studio, so students are expected to be very comfortable before even showing up on day 1 so we can tackle more data science problems during the course. Now, if you are not attending the course, don't worry, you will still learn everything you need to know about Azure Machine Learning Studio. And by the time this series is over, you should be very comfortable with Azure ML. You should be able to import and export data. You should be able to explore an unknown data set. You should be able to manipulate and transform data, mold data, pre-process data, and clean data all within Azure ML. You should be able to build and predict models inside of Azure ML. You should be able to expose those predictive models as a web service and then consume those APIs. And then you should also be able to code within Azure ML itself. This series assumes that you already have an introduction to data mining. If you do not have that introduction, go ahead and watch the video series that I've linked inside the description box, and that'll get you up to speed on what data mining is. A quick introduction about myself. I've been teaching data science and data engineering for about 3 years. I was the lead author of a 85-page lab manual on how to data mine using Azure Machine Learning Studio. I wrote 3 other books on various topics in data engineering and data science, none of which are available to the public. You have to sign up for our 5-day bootcamp to receive one of these manuals. And then I created an 11-part Azure ML tutorial series on YouTube 3 years ago when Azure ML was still in beta. And a lot has changed, which is why we're going to redo it now. And what are we going to cover in this video? Well, we're going to teach you what Azure Machine Learning Studio is, what it means to be in the cloud, and what are its benefits, the subscriptions that you need to get, and the pricing of Azure ML. Well, what is Azure Machine Learning? Well, it's also called Azure ML for short. It is a data mining and data science and machine learning tool in the cloud. But it's different than most data science tools because there's no coding involved. Traditionally, data science tools involve R or Python or MATLAB or SAS, which is all coding based. You had a terminal and you had a command line and you had to learn syntax. Not this one. This one is a drag and drop approach to machine learning. It has a visual interface and it feels more like Visio or PowerPoint than it does any other traditional data science tool. And I think this is the best tool for learning machine learning and data mining because you don't have to juggle both the syntax of learning how to program at the same time and juggle how to data mine, data mining theory, data mining frameworks, and also the theories of machine learning in general. But is this not just a tool for beginners? Advanced users will love this as well because it does a seamless integration with SQL, R, or Python, and you can mix and match. So all of a sudden, you can be using SQL, drop SQL, use a module, and then all of a sudden switch again and then go into R. I do that all the time. All right, and also, you can deploy these models automatically, meaning basically they pack up your model, throw it into the cloud somewhere, and then you can contact those models via REST APIs. And then you can connect those APIs using auto-generated code using C#, R, or Python. Azure Machine Learning is a cloud-based machine learning tool that only exists in the cloud. Specifically, it is on the Azure stack, so the Azure cloud platform. And Azure is one of the services within the Azure ecosystem itself. So Azure is the cloud platform brought to you by Microsoft. So Azure, that makes Azure ML by extension a Microsoft technology. Azure is also comparable to other cloud services like Amazon Web Services and Google Cloud Services, all of which are infrastructure as a service, meaning they are a platform that can host robust IT services that can build entire software platforms like Netflix or Snapchat. These cloud services are all software as a service where you use these services and they charge you by usage, like an electric bill or a subscription service like a cable bill. So because Azure Machine Learning Studio is a cloud-based tool, it brings with it the strengths and weaknesses of cloud computing itself. So let's go over the pros and cons of cloud computing so that you know what you're getting yourself into. So the first thing is I've noticed that none of the cloud services will almost ever ask you how much data you need to store. They will just store it and not ask any questions about that. And the reason for that is storage price especially on cloud, has been plummeting pretty consistently every year. It's gotten to the point of where it's only going to cost you about 2 cents to store anything online per gigabyte per month. So it doesn't matter if you're on AWS or on Azure, they will both charge you about 2 cents per gigabyte per month to store something, which is really cool because it basically removes data size as an equation when you have to deal with your capacity with your machine learning tools and hardware. The next thing is, machine learning does not exist in a vacuum. Machine learning is extremely dependent on large data sets. Large data sets, like big data, is dependent on IT infrastructure. So the IT infrastructure, in order to have an IT infrastructure big enough to support big data, you have to have either some kind of robust service like a data warehouse, or you can rent that stuff from AWS or Azure or Google Clouds, one of these cloud services. So specifically in Azure, you have all of that data infrastructure to back you up your machine learning. So you have, for example, Azure SQL databases as your database. You have Spark and Apache Hadoop in the form of HD Insight. You have blob storage. You have data lake storage. You have stream analytics in the form of ETL. You have Azure Data Factory in the form of orchestration of all your data pipelines. And more importantly, because it's a Microsoft technology, it integrates with Excel, which is one of the most common used BI tools in existence. The next thing is, because you're in the cloud, you're freed from hardware, right? None of your guys have to have a beeper, and you don't have a data warehouse where you have to keep upgrading the hardware. You don't have to worry about that, right? All you have to worry about is really the data and how much it's charging you on a monthly basis, okay? The next thing I find that's really cool is that it runs on someone else's machine. That doesn't sound like it means much, but the idea is you don't need a very powerful computer anymore. You don't need a workstation desktop anymore. What this means is you can get an iPad, right, and use any of these cloud-based tools, hit the run button or the execution button, and then close the tab, right? If the device can open up a browser like Chrome, right, the idea is it can run the cloud service, okay? Because it's in the cloud, it's also collaborative, which means you can invite other people to your cloud spaces and work together and share the same cloud space. And another thing, it's scalable, right? You're harnessing the entire power that is the cloud. So the cloud is very good at distributing workloads among multiple nodes, multiple servers, calling upon extra help when it needs more processing power and more storage. All right, so let's go over the cons of cloud computing. By using a cloud-based tool, you are committing to an unwavering internet connection. You can never lose internet, or you lose basically access to do your job, okay? And the next con is the biggest con of them all, right, which is compliance. Can you even be in the cloud is what that thing is trying to ask, right? Does your industry, does the government that oversees your industry, does your company, do all those policies comply such that your data can be in the cloud, right? This is all about data governance, right? So before you even use this tool and start loading data into it that is work-related, you really need to ask someone at your company, is the cloud available? And specifically, is Azure an allowed technology at this company? So I'll show you how to make an Azure Machine Learning Studio workspace in the next video, but for now, let me explain how it all works. There are two main ways to get Azure Machine Learning Studio. The first is the free trial method, and the second is the full workspace method, okay? So to get a free trial Azure ML workspace, what you do is you just simply go to the Azure ML website, sign in with your email, and you'll be given a limited access workspace. Okay. If you want a fully working workspace, then you'll need an actual Azure subscription. Then once you're inside of that subscription, go ahead and you'll have to create an Azure ML workspace within that subscription. This is the full workspace. Now, if you've never used Azure before, then Azure will give you a free trial subscription to start off. So you'll get $200 credit on your Azure subscription or 30 days, whichever limit is reached first. Now, if you've used up your Azure free trial subscription because you've used Azure before, then you'll simply need to go the pay-as-you-go route where you will add your credit card to an auto-pay system, and it will charge you for the fees that you've incurred based upon just cloud usage for the month. And for this web series, I'm going to go ahead and assume that you have a full workspace, and I'll show you how to create that full workspace in the next video. All right, let's talk about cost. So there's really two parts to the pricing of Azure Machine Learning Studio. First is the monthly subscription, and then second is for usage, okay? So first is the subscription. You are charged $9.99 per month per seat. So for each workspace, you'll be charged about $10 a month. Secondly is your charge for usage. Okay, so there's three parts to the usage, which is the first one is runtime. So you're charged $1 per 1 hour of experiment runtime. So every time you hit the run button on your experiment, you're gonna see a timer tick on the top right-hand corner of your screen. That is what you're being charged for. Okay. The second part is you're also charged for deployment calls. So anytime anyone calls your deployed web services, basically your REST APIs, for every 1,000 API calls, you're charged about 10 cents, 250 cents, okay, depending on which tier you're going with for your web service. Now, the first 1,000 API calls are basically always free. So unless you're an e-commerce business, I don't foresee you actually getting hit with these charges at all for deployment. Okay, and then the third usage is your charge for storage of data. So basically, whatever data you pull into Azure ML, okay, you'll be charged for that as well. So Azure Blob Storage which is the service we're gonna use. So Azure Blob Storage charges 2 cents per gigabyte per month. Okay, it's actually less than 2 cents, but they're gonna round it up, so it's gonna be about 2 cents. Okay, and then if you're going with the whole pay as you go for this web series, this whole web series will probably cost you $20 for the month. So $10 for the seat, and then another $10 for the usage. Now they will prorate it if you delete the workspace when you're done with it. So that's gonna be nice. All right. And then that will conclude this video. If you like these tutorials and you want to see more videos like this in the future, go ahead and like and subscribe. I'm also going to leave you with a question. What is your favorite data mining tool? Talk to me in the comment section. I'm really interested in knowing what everyone is using. All right, and I'll see you in the next video where I'll show you how to create an Azure ML workspace. And I will look forward to seeing you at our boot camp.